We have a very varied program, bringing together lots of expert knowledge about teaching and learning and training, the Chinese language and its relationship to the Chinese culture.
You know, from the beginning to the end, the whole film I take, you can see spring and you can see winter, the whole season in the film, and everyone wears the different clothes. It's quite long because I want to document a different status from a different person in this season, and there are different conditions in your life, in their life.
These concrete walls may be my jungle.
If I learn Mandarin Chinese, can I talk with most people in China?
What would you say is your favorite part of Chinese New Year?
That is a family time. My family lives away from me, so Chinese New Year, I go back to my family where my grandparents and my parents, they gather together and join a table.
The Chinese culture is bigger than you think. It's with a lot of cultures, you kind of only see what the stereotypical things, but when you really think about it, it's just as deep as our culture. When you think about your own culture, you think, oh, I didn't even realise that it was that long.
This one is the most interesting one. Oh, right.
Each one in Chinese got this
in their childhood like this. Okay. Use your waist and whole arm to move.
Okay. You can see this is bamboo handle, and this part is different from this part. It has pointed.
The fact that President Xi, in his visit to England, announced that Coventry would receive a Confucius Institute is very prestigious, and it's a mark of our standing in China that we've been awarded this very prestigious institute, this centre, for the sharing of culture and language and knowledge about China.
The creation of virtual lectures, very, very important. Examining Western perceptions of China and Chinese people, and also Chinese perceptions of the West. So that came through in the sessions that we had in the report. Looking at celebrity culture or global English, or even in the country.
So this study examined 86 email chains, so that was 307 messages. And they were written by the graduates and their correspondents. And the correspondents were from all over the world. Most of them were not native speakers of English or speakers of English as a first language.
What we're trying to do is both celebrate China and the study of China, but also trying to gain a closer understanding of the work that we're doing and the connections between different researchers and programs of research.
Yes. What's the one fact that you can take away from today about China that you've learned?
Well, it made me want to go there, doing the quiz. And the diversity, the hugeness of the country.
You can buy the pork mush and beef mush in the supermarket and cut the hoyan into pieces and put them together.
You should wait a moment, you should let them boil.
Filipino.
Okay.
I'm British.
What?
I'm Vietnamese. Why are you not Vietnamese? I'm British too.
I'm British, but I'm originally from Hong Kong.
Okay.
From Thailand.
China changed a lot and the society changed a lot and everything about money, about people's behavior all changed and tourism just a part of these changes. And I think it's happened in my hometown and I think it's really important for me to shoot everything what happened and what people do and what they pursue now.
Therefore, we can all live in decency and ignore the blocks that separate us.
An unlucky number is number 4 because it sounds like the word is pronounced similar to how they pronounce death, so that's why it's unlucky. And number 8 is lucky.
Okay. Cantonese first and then Mandarin.
Yeah, which one's
okay? 1, 2, 3. 恭喜发财.
Okay,
what's
the second one?
Mandarin.
Okay,
1, 2, 3. 恭喜发财. You're too late.
Who is?
You.
Yeah.